And I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Oh, God, my Father, I bless you this morning. I give all the glory. You are wonderful. There is no any other like you. As we worship you, Lord, you are what, God? Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. I want to welcome you, everyone. Thank you for coming. God bless you. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. Welcome once again. I'm going to talk to you the topic called Deliver Them Out of the Hand of the Wicked. Deliver them out of the hand of the wicked. We are praying for the souls. We are praying for souls. We are praying that God will bring them out of the wicked. Lord will deliver them. The Lord will deliver them from the hands of the wicked, where they have been blinded, where they have been captured, where they have been held. We pray that God will deliver them and redeem them out of the terrible one, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's look in the book of Jeremiah 15 verse 21. The book of Jeremiah 15 verse 21, the Bible says, "And I will deliver thee out of the hand of the wicked, and I will redeem thee out of the hand of the terrible." The Lord is one to deliver those people who are living in a very terrible life, who are in bondage in the hands of the enemy, who are in prison, who are being in terrible, who are in the hands of the terrible people, terrible ones. They have been blind, they have been chained, they have no idea. They have been tormented, but still they cannot call upon the name of God. Still they cannot give their life to Jesus. But the Lord has promised that he is going to deliver them. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, deliver people who are living in darkness, who are in the bondage, who are in the hands of the terrible one. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I pray that God, you are able, God. There's nothing too difficult that God you cannot do. My Father, this morning, this time, this hour, as we present our beloved one, we present our city, we present our community, we present this city of Brampton. I present this city, God, my Father. I pray for the people of Brampton, by the power and the blood of Jesus, those who are in the hands of the wicked, those who are in the hands of the terror one, Lord, I bring them to you. As you have promised, you will deliver them, God. Deliver your people, those who are being tormented in the hands of the enemy, God. My God and my Father, I declare and decree by the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray that God release them. Release them from the captivity. Release them from the bondage of the enemy. Release them, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I set fire over the enemy that is tying down the people, that is broken people from coming to God, that is holding people in captivity. I set that camp of the enemy fire. You enemy that is holding this person in captivity, you have bound them. They are dying in drugs. They have no hope. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, God has promised that he is going to deliver them. Therefore, because God has promised he's going to deliver them, I pray that God visit them. Wherever they are, God, visit them, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. We claim the scripture and confess the scripture according to the word of God, and it shall be done. Because this is the God himself say he will deliver them. I will deliver thee out of the hand of the wicked, and I will redeem them out of the hand of the terrible one. The terrible. Therefore, I am reading from the book of Acts 26, verse 18. The book of Acts 26, verse 18. The Bible says, to open their eyes in order to turn them from darkness to the light and from the powers of Satan to God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among those who are sanctified by faith in Christ. The Lord will open their eyes in order to turn them from darkness. The Lord will open their eyes. Those who are blind, those who do not see, those who are living in darkness, in the name of Jesus. This is the word of God. The word of God says, in the name of Jesus Christ, you said your word says, God, you will open their eyes in order to turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan to God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among those who are sanctified by faith. Father God, in the name of Jesus, you promise you will forgive them, God. Forgive your people, Father. Forgive all those sinners who are living in sins, who do not acknowledge you, God. I pray, my Father, touch them. Touch them, God, my Father. I pray for your husband right now. I hear the voice saying, my God, save my husband. Right now, I commit your husband right now to you. I pray that God Almighty, this man, this woman who is crying, who needs their husband to be saved, let this man be saved in Jesus' name. He shall be saved. We are praying and fasting for unbelievers. Yes, yes, my sister. I pray that God will touch your husband. And there are many, there are about 17 women who are crying. They want their husband to be saved. Receive their salvation in Jesus' name. And someone here is also crying for their children, their son. Hallelujah. Yes, your son is going to be saved. Yes, your mother is going to be saved. Your brother is going to be saved. In the mighty name of Jesus, we declare salvation all over the world. Wherever is listening these videos, your family is going to be saved in the name of Jesus. Even myself, I'm praying for my brother that he will be saved in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I'm going to receive good news because I need all of my family to be saved. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we need salvation of our family. We need salvation of our neighbor. We need salvation of our city. In the name of Jesus, I pray for the young people, people who are being lost and dying in drugs, people who are committing suicide. I pray for them, God, Lord, my Father, to touch them. God, to remove them and forgive them, Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, my God, turn them from darkness to light, God. I pray they are living in darkness. Lord, turn them according to your word. In the book of Acts 26, verse 18, Lord, my Father, open their eyes, Lord. Open their eyes to see, my God, because they have eyes, but they don't see. My God, they live in darkness. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that God deliver them. Deliver them. Every power that is holding them, all the powers of ancestors, powers of darkness, holding these people in captivity, I cut them into pieces. I cut them. I destroy them. I command the fire of God to burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. Release the people wherever they are being captured, where they are right now, from darkness to the light, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. In the book of Matthew 13, verse 7 and 22, Holy Spirit, I pray that you will cause them to hate sin and that you will break the power of those sins that are hindering them from coming to Christ. I pray that God, my Father, I pray that you will cause them to hate sin and that you will break the power of those sins that are hindering them from coming to Christ. Any sin, any power hindering them from coming to Jesus, I break them. I destroy them. I break every power of sin. Any sin that is hindering somebody, that sin that you want to enjoy your life before you come to Christ, and you don't know tomorrow where you will be. Suppose you die right now, where will you be? I pray that any sin that make you cannot give your life to Jesus, that you want to enjoy your life and then you can come to Jesus, I break that sin. I destroy that sin. Fornication, anything that drugs, anything that make people not to give their life to Jesus, corruption, bribing, all these sins that make people not to give their life to Jesus, I break them. I destroy them. I bind them and render them powerless in the name of Jesus. I am standing against the powers of darkness. I break every sin that are hindering people from coming to Christ. What kind of a sin is that? Is it a boyfriend? Is it a girlfriend? Yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, I destroy that relationship that is making people not to give their life to Jesus. All children of that devil that is connecting with the children of God and deceiving them. You dragon and python, get out of this woman. Get out of this child. In fact, I see a snake rounding somebody. And maybe, let me put it like this. Maybe you have been dreaming a snake, seeing snakes. Or when you pray, you see snakes. Or you have been dreaming that snakes is biting you. This python, they cannot let you to be saved. They cannot let you even to get married. They cannot get you even to enjoy the life that God has given you. Therefore, I command the fire of God to burn to the ashes every python, every snake around these people. That they are being make them, they cannot receive Jesus. Let those snakes be burned to ashes in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the book of Mark 9 verse 43, Mark 9 verse 43 to 47. Father, I ask for your angels to surround and protect those people today that are without Jesus, without God, and without any hope at all. Protect them in all they are going out and coming in today. Forgive forevermore. I claim that the shed blood of Jesus right now is covering every non-believer's body, spirit, and souls in Jesus' name. In the book of Ephesians 1:4, the Bible says, You said that you are already from this foundation of the world, predestining this for greatness, and that is why the gospel is veiled, because their mind, the God of this age, as blind who do not believe, rest the right of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them. Father, I pray from the book of Ephesians 1:4, you said that you have already from the foundation of the world predestined this from greatness, and that is why the gospel is valid, because their mind, the God of this age, has blinded, who do not believe, lest the right of the gospel of the God, glory of Christ, who is the image of God. Father, I pray, because of the gods of this world has blinded them, they do not understand, they cannot give their life to Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, the God of this world, the God of these ages has blinded them. Father, in the name of Jesus, every God of this age that is blinding people not to give their life to Jesus, I destroy them, I bind them, I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. But I loose forth the mighty weapon of God that will pull down every stronghold that Satan has erected in their minds and in their hearts. I ask you, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, according to the word, according to the word that you gave your only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life, and that you sent not your Son unto the world to be condemned, but the world through him might be saved, as it is written in John 3:16-17. Father, according to Acts 4:12, here is known an other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. And you said in Joel 2:32, hallelujah, my God. And you said in the book of Joel 2:32, that it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. I pray that, Father, as I'm asking that, Father, those lost souls will confess with their mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in their heart that God has raised him from dead, so that they will be saved. For with the heart one believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth confess is made unto salvation, according to Romans 10:9-10. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that God deliver your people. I pray that God my Father, for with the heart one believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth confess is made unto salvation, according to Romans 10, verse 9 to 10. Father, I pray that God, you are people who are living in darkness, who do not know you, my Father, this family. I pray for my community. I pray right now for my community to be saved. My God, my Father, I break every gods. I break every powers of gods. Any gods that is holding people captivity, that they cannot be saved. I bring them down and destroy them. I break them. I destroy their gods. I destroy their evil altars. I break them and I destroy them. I bring the fire of God to burn their altars, to burn their condoling, to burn their covenants in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every blood boil under our city, our community, that they will not let anybody to be saved. You are a liar. That blood, I set them fire. That ground you are claiming, I destroy them. That ground does not belong to you. It belongs to God. It belongs to our Father. My Father, pray and pronounce and speak to your community, to the ground. Speak to your city. Speak to your people. Anything that I've said, I've denied their salvation, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Every power that is denying salvation to your people, anything that is holding them, Lord, my Father, I cut them off in Jesus' name. I pray that let the power of Holy Ghost fire destroy every strong man, strongest power holding these people in captivity. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. Glorious God, I honor you. Now, God, in Numbers 23:19, you said that you are not a man that you should lie, nor the son of man that you should repent. Father, you are not a man to lie. You are a God of truth. You are a God of impossibility. Because you promised this, therefore, Father, I pray according to your word, according to your scripture, my God. In Isaiah 46, verse 10 to 11, you say that your counselor shall stand and you will do all your pleasures. You have spoken salvation and deliverance to those and you will bring it to pass. You have purposed it and you will do it. Father, thank you. Thank you because you have purposed. You purposed and you have said and you will do it because you are not a liar to lie. You will deliver your people. You will bring deliverance to your people. In my Father, salvation has come. Jesus Christ has delivered God. The prophet prophesies about the salvation. The prophet prophesies about the Savior who will come to the world to save your people. Jesus Christ has come to the world to save us, to save the people, my God. And my Father, you are not a liar to lie, my God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Father, according to Romans 4, verse 20 to 21, like Abraham, I am faithfully persuaded that you and you alone are able to perform that which you have promised in your word, according salvation, concerning salvation for every lost soul. Father, I thank you that according to Luke 1, verse 37, with you, God, nothing is ever impossible. And no word from you shall be withdraw power or impossible or fulfillment that you are alert and active, watching over your word to perform, according to Jeremiah 1:12. God, my Father, you have said that nothing is ever impossible, and no word from you shall be without power or impossible of fulfillment, and that you are alert and active, watching over your word to perform it, according to Jeremiah 1:12. Father, let your word be performed. Let your word be performed. Let your word do what you have said, God. You are God, you have said you are not God of impossibility. God, you are not, there is nothing impossible to you. Father, I thank you. Everything is possible. As we bring our beloved, we bring our family, we bring every one of our family into your hand, God. I pray that God, my Father, In the name of Jesus, I want to thank you, Lord. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, glorious God, we thank you. We give all the glory. We give all the glory and honor. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Savior, we love you, Lord. We thank you. We magnify my Father. We magnify, we give you the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. I want to thank everyone. Thank you for coming. I know God has touched so many lives. Watch them. There are thousands. People are want to hear these videos. Their beloveds will be saved. This video is very powerful video than any other video. This is the soul win video. I'm going to call soul win video. Yes, soul win video. My God, I thank you for this video. This video is going to change a lot of lives of people. I am praying based on scripture according to the word of God. And you will take this video, put it to your listen it all the time, and claim if you have people in your family who are not been saved, these videos want to touch them and they want to be saved. This is the video from prompted by the Holy Spirit. We've been praying for prayer and fasting. This package of the videos, you will see it is going to touch many, many, many lives. I pray and prophesy wherever we listen this video will be saved. Your family who have been tormented, who have been living in bondage, are going to be set free through this video. I attack every strong man, any power that is holding people in captivity to be destroyed in Jesus' name. I bind the powers of ancestors that is holding people from being saved. I destroy them. I destroy every power of the enemy that is working against the people. Those people cannot be saved in Jesus' name. I am attacking witchcraft that is holding people in captivity, that they cannot be able to give their life to God in Jesus' name. Tonight, I'm going to speak the word against those people that are being programmed by evil, that they will be set free and they will give their life to Jesus. By tomorrow, we are going to have so many testimonies and many people are going to give their life to Jesus. I know that God can, His word cannot go back to heaven without doing what it has says. Remember, the Bible says God is not a liar to lie. God is going to do it. Many people are going to be saved. We pray that God will save your people. Will save those people you have been praying for many years. You have been fasting, trusting God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We love you. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for touching the life of the people. Thank you for big, big, big salvation. My God and my Father, I thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. I want to thank everyone. Thank you for coming. On 1st of July, here in Canada, we have Canada Day. So we will be having deliverance called High on Feet Deliverance. High on Feet Deliverance is very powerful deliverance that we are going to carry, and you will come in fasting. We will be fasting 3 days. That is Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. You come in fasting. We will have a party after that. We'll have a dinner. We'll have a party. We'll have turkey. We'll have food. So we'll enjoy and celebrate Canada Day, evening dinner. And we will start our prayer 7:30. We'll finish 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock is we'll finish. Then we'll have time to celebrate and enjoy. I invite everyone to come and join us. If you want to come from another country, wherever you are welcome, let us know. And if you are living around here, Ontario, wherever in Canada, you are most welcome. This deliverance is going to keep you for the next few months before the end of the year. Remember, the month of July is the month of fulfillment. So that we want you to be fulfilled. Everything you have been praying, God is going to meet you. So join us on 7 p.m. 7 p.m., not a.m. We have the prayer in the morning and in the evening. So you, both of them, but in our deliverance, that is what is going to happen. So please join us in Jesus' name. We thank you and we praise God and we pray that you we will see you there in Jesus' name. I want to stop here. I thank God for those who have come. These videos, I'm going to pull it. I'm going to upload and it is going to be in YouTube soon. Because I feel like people need this video. The last night video and this one, they are the same. So you will continue with this one and the other one. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you very much for coming. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. Love you. I love you. There is nothing I can do. Remember to go to our website. Thank you, my sister. Deborah, you are a wonderful. God bless you, my sister. Your family, I want to be saved in the name of Jesus. My dear Deborah, I love you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. And also, you can call us, our number, 877-241-3420, extension 101. Also, you can WhatsApp our cell phone number, 647-608-5207. Our cell phone number, 647-608-5207. Also, we have, yes, I'm from Canada. I'm from Canada. So our number is 905-487-7196. This is our number to reach me. If you want to call me, get that number. The number is on the screen. So you can stop and copy that number. If you cannot copy, here, listen, our number, if you have a cell phone, you can, you want to know where I'm originated from. I'm from Kenya. What about you? Where are you from? Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Our number to reach us, or Sudan. Sudan is our neighbor. So call me, I will pray for you. My cell phone number is 647-608-5207. Thank you very much. Mambo, Habari, you speak my language. Anyway, Somalia, they are in our neighbor, so we share the language. That's okay. I thank you, my brother. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So call me, I will pray for you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, my sister, you speak too. Thank you so much. Yes, please sow to our ministry an amount. Go to our website and donate an amount. You can send your donation through Western Union, through money order, through email. And also, you can go to a pattern called donation. You can donate an amount and God will bless you. This time, as we are going to do the deliverance, the month of July, you will see the blessings of God that you have never seen before. Thank you. PayPal, yes, you can go to PayPal and donate an amount that the Lord will speak to you. If God is telling you, donate 1,000, because God knows you have 1,000, you will obey and donate. If God says an amount, God will ask you to donate, obey the Holy Spirit and it shall be well with you. Thank you so much and have a wonderful time. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Once again, I say, I love you. I love you. I love you. I'm a lover. I love you. I love you. Honestly. Thank you so much. And God bless you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. Once again, I'm your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi, saying bye-bye to you. Bye.